Vite in facinum, o Spiritus te negrarum. Pane, astero te iubero. Impre te unc lapidem, impre te eum vibritus, sulfuratis vestris.
Might have to go and see the guy at the front on the desk, Hugh. There's a guy on the desk, he might know where all the lights are. Here we are, in the galleries. Stuart's just going to put the device on his phone, see if we get any.
Just 10 of that VIP.
Oh yeah, baby. Back into the cell. Yeah. Try it in there. Remember, it was spiking in red last time, didn't it, when we were down there where we
were? Yeah, that was sort of around here. Yeah.
What's the saying?
It says important. Are you somebody important? There's something important you've got to tell us.
If there is, see that device that my friend's holding there? Just see if you can come along and just talk to us. Let us know that you're here.
So that people know what this is, basically the software in this is potentially if a spirit is present, it talks into the phone to the software. The software will decipher what the spirit is saying and come up with the words here.
So come on, can you give us a name?
There's someone who used to be in this cell.
I think this is one of the cells where there's quite a lot of prisoners held. Up to 12 to 13 prisoners at once. And they all obviously all used to be in it together. Can you imagine that? Not a stench.
Yeah.
Must have been in really bad condition. Can you throw something?
You see that flash of light?
Yeah.
Ah,
talking to this device. Can you give me a name? Mate. Yeah, I just do that, just trying to like down to her and see what I'm going on, I'm going to fall over and break everything. Cheers, mate. Right, I think we should head.
This is the laundry room.
Yeah, we go there, yeah. A lot of activities happened in there, mate. Stuart, did you make a whistling noise then?
Sorry?
Did you just whistle then? This one either.
What's Natalie?
What's his name?
Natalie. Like Carolyn Natalie.
That's two women's names down in the women's area. Man. That's a bit bizarre, isn't it?
Supposed to be very active, and I've had the names Natalie and Carol come up on the voice box. And again, it's going.
Try and make it go into the red, it's in the green at the moment, so if you could just try and. If your energy's around us. You show us by light form that you're here. Carol Pierce.
Is there a Carol Pierce or a Natalie Pierce here? Again, I'll take a picture of that. Because it'd be interesting then if
we can look back on the document. Right, put your light on and let's see where this lawn is. It through there?
Yeah.
Yeah, this is where objects are meant to move on their own. In this room. The Pierce, is there someone named Pierce?
Is it a Natalie Pierce or a Carol Pierce? We're not here to harm you, we're here to investigate. I'm very curious about the afterlife.
Did you just cough then, or?
No.
What did you hear? Yeah, I heard.
What was that? Was the door shut? Yeah, there's people in that room and talking.
Oh, yeah.
Can I remember Natalie Pierce here? Or a Carol Pierce? About the matron? Being very proud woman.
Do you know? Yeah. Pierce would obviously be a surname, wouldn't it?
Well, it's come up with, I've had a Natalie Pierce come through and a Carol. Mm. But it's strange because it just went to say something and it went blank.
That's why I stopped?
Yeah, just totally went blank.
Okay.
What's the name of the matron you used to work down here? Can you give me your name, please? You just have to watch the battery life on it. You want to speak to us? Can you make a banging noise or throw something? Okay, if we go. Outside.
Come on, make that spike. Make it spike.
Did you die here? Shift tonight.
Or do you want us to shift?
Are we in your way? As in, you're asking us to get out of the way? Or are you saying we're working?
Nothing on the, not spiking at all, is it?
No.
Okay. Now he's using his phone. Camera's fine, so he didn't get any. Let's come up.
Debbie.
Getting out a bit late.
You matron. Cave
there. Did it?
Yeah.
Oh, it's come up with cave?
Yeah. I don't know if it came up, flashed, yeah, cave.
My camera's going all weird. It's going all blurry.
Is it?
It's right now. It just went blurry then. Cave.
Cave.
It's on about the medieval caves.
You're on about the medieval caves?
Then we can get down there.
He wants to go down there?
Oh, it's my stomach rumbling.
So magic somewhere.
I'm
just
thinking.
What was it? What was it? It was through here. There was a little hanging.
Yeah, somebody in there in that bit.
Yeah, I think so. You got on that device, it said K.
I've had three names and K. Smell.
Is that what it said after it?
Mm.
Oh, that's interesting.
Apparently, a black mass actually came out and threw somebody up against the wall.
It's quite a lot of black and white, yeah. Went into the wall.
Has that been brought to you? It wouldn't be quiet.
Sorry, let's give you guys to their investigation.
I don't want to disturb too much.
From what
you
just mentioned,
it's more so
on the cave.
That's
a dead end
there. Sorry, guys. It's a cave and then
this
smell.
This is definitely one of the areas we did, though, so it's got to be
ready. All this talk is just
going
on here. Aren't they?
This has changed.
The thing is, the weird thing is, when I focused on you this day, it went blur. I've never known to do that before.
Yeah.
My camera, yeah. I've never done that before, ever. Come on.
This device here is a laser pen. Basically what we do is we put it on the wall, and if anything, any spirits or anything go in front of it, it will create a shadow. That's the option. Does it stay on?
No, you have to keep your finger on it.
So keep this here for a minute. We've also got the EMF reader on there as well. Are there any spirits in this room? Can you make a noise? Can you walk in front of this green light?
Are you?
Yeah. So, across on there, you'll see a green light. Can you make that change colour for me, please? Can you make a noise? Can you bang?
Can you come through the doorway? Can you make the, what do they call it?
Flaps, I suppose.
Yeah. Can you make the flaps move? You show us by light for me here. Knock, tap on something. Come on, we've come a long way. Can you move the chair? Move the chairs? Come on, really bang on something. We know you've got the energy to do it. There's a light above the table. Can you make that move?
The fuck was that?
Hmm?
What the fuck was that?
What do you mean?
Didn't you hear that?
No. No? What did you hear?
Fucking heart's pounding now. It was either a or something sliding across, like a table.
There's a light orb just gone past your face then. Okay, we've established that someone's here. Well, you're a while with us. So can you do something? You make that noise again? Show us by shadow. You touch one of us. Nothing on that?
No.
Not weird. But I'm getting light on this. You're not. There's something like a chair moving. Can you move one of the chairs? Here last time. Okay, it's me all, mate.
I saw a shadow there of a person. I came round.
Yeah.
I thought I saw a shadow walk across there. Come on, is anybody here?
I thought I saw a shadow again then. A shadow, or is it going to move across in front of us? Yeah, I've got a light orb then.
Might have been dust when I just walked through.
Come on, show yourself in front of us. Walk towards the camera, walk towards the red light. Come on, use our energy. Use the energy from this camera. Do you have a feeling that something's going to happen? I'm getting that feeling as well. There's some steps there. Can you push the steps over? Spikes and whatsoever since we've started.
We should leave this room, this area. I don't think it's just flat.
That won't make much, yeah.
So we're done in the cave now. This one. Voice.
That voice.
Oh, right.
Can you hear your voice?
Can you go down here? Yes. Let's just hear your voice then. Tell us your name.
Come up with several.
Did you haunt down here?
What questions do you ask prior to that? Good to say that.
My answer was down here, then I said about we're down in the caves now. And then it came up to yes. And it said six.
Why
six? Are there six of you down here?
Real.
Also, what I would like to ask is, sorry for the guys who have got camcorders, but can we switch off the infrared light, please? Thank you. Let's see. Yeah. Stick close to the wall.
Okay. That's what I'm trying to do.
Thank you.
Do you want me to keep mine? Spirit box up, or do you want me to get
up? Spirit box is fine. It was the infrared light can affect manifestation, so it's something that I wanted to reduce an impact on. Okay. Now, I'm going to give you a rundown of what happened here before. During the experiment before, we ended up picking up, especially from this location, we started picking up the sounds of someone who was breathing heavily. And we were manipulating the environment with the frequency. That's something we want to come back and try and address.
Yeah.
So as we searched the resonance of this particular room, there are particular items within the room that will resonate at particular frequencies, and you will hear this as we go through the scale. Although we're using one speaker, it sounds very peculiar, especially whenever you start hitting the resonance of the brick, of the stone, and including us, we will resonate at particular frequencies. That's something we want to address. What we're hoping to do is to reach the lower chambers. And what may happen as well is that when we switch this off, you may begin to hear the feedback of that frequency coming through the walls. Okay, that's something we want to listen out for as well. As well as that person who was heavily laden. Be particular as well about being touched, anything you can, as we continue. So I'm just going to switch this light out, folks. And the only light will be this particular tablet that I'm using. So we're going to start off at a lower frequency, around 90 Hz, and then we'll start migrating our way through the frequency band. If anyone does hear anything unusual, note it, and whenever I switch this off, then tell me about it, okay?
Do you want me to inform of any words if I have any come through?
Yes, please okay. Do, yep. Uh-huh.
forces as well just come through.
Hear what sounds like a car engine.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yep. I gotta ask as well, sorry, I can't remember your name.
Stuart.
Stuart, did you sigh just before I switched this off?
I didn't sigh, no.
Okay, it came from this direction?
Right. Unless it was this.
No, it was definitely it was definitely a sigh. We're calling on the spirits of this place, of this cave, to come forward to us. Do you understand my request? And you step forward to us here, in this place.
He's asking for your name.
My name is Barry Fitzgerald. I'm from Ireland. Do you understand? Can you give us an impression of who you are? I ask that you come forward and stand with me and meet me halfway. Do you understand?
Trinity, come on.
The power of three is a very effective and powerful number. How long have you lived in these caves? Are there other caves? Can you indicate to me where these caves are?
Just come up the noise.
The noise?
Yes, the noise.
Folks, that is that it? Again, I refer back to the sounding like an engine, a car engine.
I hear the car engine now.
Yeah. Still
where is it coming from? Which wall?
That's what's behind me.
Yeah. Sounds like it's above me.
Malcolm, would you agree it's coming from your side?
I think.
Oh, you've moved over.
It's towards that wall over there.
Okay.
Yeah.
I wonder if that's what it means while it moves.
But that's what I'm wondering. Is it indicating it's over there? Are you able to come through into this chamber? I have to say, I don't recall hearing that noise whenever we started.
Disembodied.
Yeah. It's better than disembowel, I suppose. So you can come through into this chamber. I also know that you're able to form. You can form into a shape. Into a figure. Can you appear to us in this room?
With Quran.
Okay.
Keeping this side next to me.
Hmm?
Keeping this something right next to me.
We mean you no disrespect at all. And I do thank you for giving us some time in which we could communicate. I thank you for that, and I hope we can do it again sometime.
Can you give us your name? Can you speak to this device? It's a shift.
Thank you. And goodbye.
From our vigil with Barry Fitzgerald, which was a bit of an honour, to be honest. And we're now, where are we, Stu? We're in the laundry room.
We're in the laundry room, which is meant to have a lot of activity. And there was a group in here earlier. We didn't come in because the door was shut, but we heard a lot going on, so we'll see. But just to give you, it's absolutely pitch dark in here. I know it's hard to say because the camera's on, you see through the camera, but there's a little bit of light there, but apart from that, again, I'm using my EMF reader, so if it goes off the green and goes to any other colour, then we know we've got some kind of energy in the room. There's no electrical cables in here that would affect it.
No. Okay, I'm going to do a bit of a call out. Are there any women here in the room with us? If you're with us, Can you make a noise? Can you talk to us? You tell us what your name is? The last time I was here, you managed to show me in a light form and you came towards the camera. Can you do the same again? Now, again, there's a lot of items around the room that you can move for us. At the table, I'll go and touch my friend Stuart. Can you move the curtains? Please come forward, we don't mean you any harm at all. We've come from a great distance to come and see you.
That was me.
Don't be afraid. Come and join us. My name's Mark.
And I'm Stuart.
We're just very interested in knowing that you actually exist, that you're part of this building. Come and talk to us. There's a red light on my camera that I'm using. You know, come towards it so I can hear your voice. Please. Are you on the bed?